Each airport in the National Airspace System has unique and distinct characteristics. This can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas from the flight deck. Ohio State University is a small to medium-sized, primarily corporate and general aviation airport located in the northwest part of the city of Columbus, Ohio. The airfield is home to the Ohio State University's flight education program. From basic pre-solo students through advanced ratings, the university provides the bulk of the traffic at this airport. The rest of Ohio State University's traffic consists of corporate aviation as well as a robust Medivac community. Approximately 10 miles southeast of the Ohio State University Airport is John Glenn Columbus International, and the runway configurations of these two airports are somewhat similar. These airports have been confused for one another in the past. With such a wide variety of pilot experience and aircraft capability, the Ohio State Airport presents a challenging environment for controllers and pilots alike. The runway configuration consists of two parallel runways with staggered thresholds labeled 9er left and right and 27 left and right, along with intersecting runway 5 and 23. This runway crosses runway 9er right 27 left but ends short of the north parallel. The taxiway system provides access to all services, facilities, and businesses located on the north and south sides of the airport. As with any airport with parallel runways with staggered thresholds, the opportunity for wrong surface landings exists. Pilots are reminded to check the airport layout thoroughly and understand that they may be assigned either runway. Positively identifying your assigned runway will help avoid such serious errors. Hotspot 1 is located on Taxiway Alpha west of runway 523. Aircraft instructed to hold short of runway 9er right on Alpha must completely cross the hold short line for intersecting runway 523. If your aircraft is not completely across this line, then runway 523 becomes unusable. Adding to the possible confusion of where to hold short may be the ILS critical area hold line, found approximately halfway between the runway 9er right hold bar and the runway 523 hold bar. A complete understanding of taxiway markings and ATC clearances will help pilots avoid this type of error. Hotspot 2 is located just east of Hotspot 1 and concerns aircraft crossing hold short bars for runway 523 while taxiing for departure on runways 5 or 9er left and right. The hold short bars located on Taxiway Alpha 1 and Taxiway Alpha are a significant distance back from runway 523 and almost immediately upon entering the movement area. Keeping eyes outside the cockpit while taxiing and understanding your taxi clearance, including route, turns, and hold short instructions, before beginning to move, will make it easier for pilots to comply with ATC instructions. Hotspot 3 is located at the intersection of runways 523, 9er left 27 right, and taxiways Charlie and Foxtrot. The primary issue here concerns aircraft on taxiway Charlie cleared for takeoff on runway 27 right. After receiving the clearance,
cross runway 23, runway 27 right, cleared for takeoff.
Several aircraft have mistakenly turned onto runway 23 and tried to depart. The proximity of the runway ends and the unusual airport geometry may contribute to this mistake. The tower has tried to help this situation by utilizing the phraseology, cross runway 23, cleared for takeoff runway 27 right. Another way for pilots to avoid this error is a last minute heading check after lining up on the runway, but before applying takeoff power. Check the aircraft heading against the runway cleared to use and they should match. If they do not, stop and resolve the issue. Another issue occurring in the same general area, but not listed as part of the hotspot, concerns aircraft landing runway 9er left and clearing the runway to the south. Instead of making the slight right turn onto Charlie, pilots have turned further right and attempted to taxi via runway 23. Pilots, please note, you must have a specific clearance to operate on any runway, active or not. If you are ever in doubt of any instruction, clearance, or even your own location on the airport, the easiest answer is to ask the tower. They are there to help. Controllers would much rather spend a few extra seconds explaining things than processing a runway incursion or worse. However, with this in mind, there are occasionally times in which the tower will taxi aircraft on a runway to help expedite traffic or deconflict flows to and from the active runways. This sort of procedure can occasionally be the source of pilot confusion, which may lead to a runway incursion. Pilots taxiing from the south side of the airport and cleared runway 27 right, taxi via Alpha, runway 523, hold short runway 9er right, 27 left, have missed the only sign telling them where to hold short and fouled runway 9er right, 27 left, causing either a go-around or canceled takeoff clearance. This is a somewhat understandable mistake given there is only one sign that tells pilots where to hold short, and it is located on the left side of the runway immediately after making the turn from Alpha onto runway 523. There are no markings on the runway itself or on the right side of the runway. Controllers will try and clarify this for pilots, but it is still up to the pilot to comply with these instructions. The last area to be discussed is the non-movement versus movement area issue found on the south side of the airport, primarily concerning the west ramp. Pilots have crossed the pavement markings without clearance. You must have an ATC clearance to taxi from a non-movement to a movement area. Keeping your eyes scanning outside the aircraft will help you identify the markings and signs that advise pilots where and when they need such a clearance. One last note for transient helicopter traffic. Due to the ramp configuration and the number of ground movements, pilots can expect to land on the runways and not be cleared directly to the ramp. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at Ohio State University will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the ATC tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the Ohio State University Airport. It's always better to know before you go.